transfusion. First, I'll come in. Knock, knock. Hi. Hi, I'm Diana. I'm going to be your nurse today. How are you doing? Okay. I'm going to go ahead and wash my hands first. And then, can I just go ahead and get your name and date of birth, please?
Ruby Curia, 13095.
Okay, and then do you have any allergies to any medications?
No.
Okay. We're going to be doing blood transfusion, so I see in the chart that you have signed consent, so I would check for that first. Have you gone over with the doctor the procedure? Do you have any questions about it?
No.
Okay. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to take my line, the normal saline, and first I'm going to check for patency of your IV. So I'll have my 10 milliliter saline flush, and I'll go ahead and put on gloves and assess your IV site so it doesn't look like she has colitis or infiltration of any sort. Go ahead and insert my 10 mil normal saline flush and check for blood return. Looks like there's blood return, so I'm gonna go ahead and flush it with about 5 to 10 milliliters of saline. Once I've done that, I'm gonna go ahead and prime my tubing with normal saline. So go ahead and take this. I don't want to drop this below my waist because these are sterile. So what's going to happen? I'm going to prime it with that. Thank you. Once that's verified, I have 30 minutes to get the blood from the blood bank to be able to infuse into the patient. So I'll come back up and I'll get another nurse to come over, and then I'll go ahead and cross check this with the basic. Sorry, can I get your name and date of birth again?
Rio, 1385.
Okay, and any allergies? Okay. And then I'll go ahead and double check the name, date of birth, blood type, blood product, RH factor, expiration date. With the other nurse, once she verifies that, she'll sign off on it. And then I'm going to check the blood bag for any coagulation, sediment, discoloration, just to make sure that the blood isn't contaminated. So after I check and verify that everything looks okay, I'm going to go ahead and get her vital signs 5 minutes prior to infusion. So I'm going to do that now before I prime my line with blood. So get her baseline vital signs in case I have something to compare to in case she has an adverse reaction. Before I paint my blood, I'm going to agitate the cells to get the red blood cells back into suspension. So I'll just flip it around a little bit. Normal saline tubing ready to go and just check everything. she received it in, and then how she tolerated it, so she had a reaction.